Howdy y'all, and welcome back to the first episode in our tabulation series. In this video, we'll look at ballot inventory controls. These aren't knobs that you turn on some special machine. Ballot inventory controls are the security measures that make sure only official ballots get counted in an election. They're security measures used before polls open, during the election, and after the polls close. Knowing the number of ballots that exist before the election is a key piece of the tabulation puzzle. Idaho County clerks are required by state law to keep a record of both the number of ballots pre-printed and the number of those ballots issued to each polling location on election day. Some locations may use technology to print ballots on demand, either for early or election day voting. These on-demand voting systems still must track the number of ballots printed, and for what precinct, so those numbers can be added to the ballot inventory. Having this pre-election number gives election officials the starting point for their post-election review, also called a canvass. We'll discuss canvasses in the last episode of this series. During the election, ballots are removed from inventoried pads or sealed packages by poll workers and issued to voters after they sign the poll book. In this way, the number of signatures in the poll book can be compared to the number of ballots remaining to look for any issues. To be sure that ballots can't be photocopied, state law requires unique markings that prevent duplication of a ballot. Many jurisdictions will add a special stamp, changed at every election, for additional security. These same anti-duplication safeguards apply to absentee and early voting ballots as well, even if they are printed on demand. By comparing the number of ballots issued to the voter count from the poll books, election officials can balance the ballot inventory at the close of the polls. They aren't to the finish line yet, though. They still have to subtract the spoiled ballots. A spoiled ballot may have been damaged, mismarked by a voter, or for some reason is unreadable. It will be put in a special location with other spoiled ballots to keep the inventory control on track. Finally, if a voter brings their unmarked absentee ballot to the polls, that absentee ballot is also spoiled before they can vote in person. Ballot inventory controls. A lot of math that makes sure each voter only gets one chance to be heard in an election, and a key part of the tabulation process. Now, give me a wave, because that thing at the end of your arm? Well, join me in the next episode where we'll talk about the specific steps and controls used in hand counting ballots. High five, and see you soon.